All right, guys, it's time to show what you're made of. Here's another code challenge. And this one is, again, another difficult challenge. And the arms really show you just how difficult it is. But you're going to flex and you're going to get stronger. And it's only through struggle that you're going to become a better coder. So in this code exercise, we're going to build a love calculator. And the way that it's going to work is the same method that I used when I was 10, pretty much. And I really recommend reading up on this particular BuzzFeed article, which is, of course, very reputable, and it's going to tell you exactly how this program is going to work. So once you've managed to scroll past all the GIFs, it will tell you the method. So you write your name, his or her name, and then the words true and love. Now then, you're going to count the number of times T-R-U-E occur in both of your names, and then you're going to count the number of times L-O-V-E occur in both of your names. Once you've got those numbers, so here T-R-U-E adds up to 6, L-O-V-E adds up to 3, then you'll get the percentage that you are compatible with this other person. So not only do you get to learn programming on this course, you also get to discover your destiny. The idea is that we're going to convert this very time-consuming process into a computer program. So once you've understood how it works, you're going to write the code for it. Now, in order to be able to calculate the love score, there's two important things that you should read in the hint. One is you will need to use the lower function. And all that this does is it takes a string, let's say we've got the string Angela, and notice how that first letter is a capital A. If I write dot lower parentheses, then it will reduce all of the capital letters to lowercase letters. And if you were wondering how you would have known to use this, then you can head over to this Stack Overflow question in which somebody asks exactly this question: how do you turn something that's uppercase into a lowercase character in Python? The second function you'll need is the count function, and this will give you the number of times a letter occurs in a string, which is super useful when it comes to this particular challenge. So again, let's use our string Angela, and then I'm going to write count, and then in between the parentheses, I'm going to specify what it is that I want to count. So let's say I want to count the character A inside this string, and I hit enter, it comes up with 1. Even though you can see there's actually 2 A's in this string in my name, it only counts 1 lowercase a. So that's why this first step was super, super useful. So let's say lowercase name equals Angela dot lower, and then let's go ahead and do lowercase name dot count, and then we're going to count for A again. Now you'll see it gives us 2 because we were able to convert everything to lowercase and then use the count function to check the number of times the character A occurs in this string. And again, I've linked to a Stack Overflow question, which is how you might have found out to use this count function and how you might use it in terms of code examples. Now, there's a second step to this challenge, because not only do we want to know the love score, we also want to give the user an interpretation. So the interpretation is here. For love scores that are less than 10, or greater than 90, the message is going to say your score is X, and of course replace that X with the actual score. You go together like Coke and Mentos. Now, if their love score was between 40 and 50, the message is going to read your score is whatever it may be. You are all right together. And finally, for all other scores, the message is just going to give them their score. Your score is XYZ. In this case, there's 2 inputs, somebody's name and then somebody else's name, and then you're going to check for the number of times T-R-U-E occurs in both of those names, L-O-V-E occurs in those names, then you're going to combine these digits together to get the love score. Pause the video now, have a look at everything that's in the instructions, read it all, and then go ahead and give that a go. All right, so the first step is to work out the love score, right? So we need to figure out how many times each of these letters occur in these names. The first thing that we need to do is to combine the names, because we're looking for the number of times, let's say, T occurs in these names, and we're treating them as one string, right? So I don't want to check it separately and then have to add it together. So let's call it a combined string, and let's set that to equal name one plus name two. And this is just going to concatenate those two strings together. So we'll be able to check them only once. Makes it more efficient, right? The next step is to guard against cases where the user's inputting their name like this, which many people do, or they might even write it like this. So we have to turn everything into lowercase. So let's call it lowercase string. And that will be combined string dot lower, just as I demoed previously using this lower function. So now we've got everything in lowercase, we're going to start checking for this first word, T-R-U-E. So let's first check how many times the letter T occurs in this lowercase string of both people's names. So we can say lowercase string dot count, and then inside the parentheses, we specify the string we're looking for, which is T. And then I'm going to save this to a variable, which I'll just call T again. And then we're going to repeat this several times. Hopefully, for practice sake, you'll type it all out. But in my case, I'm just going to copy and paste it, which is usually error prone, but we'll try to be careful. So now that we've got the number of times T occurs, R occurs, U, and E occurs, we can now add it all up. So let's say true equals T plus R plus U plus E. So now we've got the first digit of our love score. And we have to go ahead and do the same thing for L-O-V-E. So again, for time's sake, I'm just going to copy that and then go ahead and change this to L-O-V-E and L-O-V-E. And then I'm going to go ahead and calculate the total for that, which is going to be L plus O plus V plus E. And now I've got both of these numbers, and I'm going to try and concatenate them together to achieve this two-digit number. To do that, I'm going to create a love score variable that's going to keep hold of this, and then I'm going to say true plus love. And remember that at this stage, both true and love are actually integers. That's how we were able to add them together. So if I want to turn them into a string in order to be able to concatenate them together, I have to convert them to strings. The final thing we have to do is just to go ahead and print this love score. So we're not going to print anything else for now. Let's just go ahead and test it out. So let's run our code and let's type my name and then their name, Jack Bauer, of course, and then it gives us the score. So 5, 3. So that means everything so far has pretty much worked. So now all we have to do is use our knowledge of if statements to give a corresponding interpretation or a message. If the score is less than 10 or greater than 90, so if love score is less than 10 or love score is greater than 90, so we're using that logical or operator here to check if either this condition or this condition is true. And if you find it helpful, which I usually do, it's easier to wrap these conditions in their own set of parentheses. Now, Python doesn't actually care. Either method works, but for us humans, this is a little bit more readable. So under this condition, what we're going to print out is Your love score is, and then we'll insert the love score variable here. And we're going to, of course, be using F strings, so let's add that. And then we're going to write you go together like Coke and Mentos. So that's our first condition done. Now, the next condition is, what if their love score is between 40 and 50? So let's go ahead and add an elif here. Elif, the love score, is greater than or equal to 40. And the love score is less than or equal to 50. So that catches the cases where the love score is between 40 and 50. So both of these conditions must be true for this statement to fire. And in this case, what we want to do is we want to print out this sentence. So your score is, let's just insert the love score in here. Your score is this particular love score. You are all right together. Now, the final thing we said is, if it doesn't match any of these conditions, then the message is just going to be their score. So that means we can catch everything else using an else statement, and we can simply just print, your score is this particular number. Now, at this stage, you might think you're done. But if you actually run it, you're going to get an error. So let's go ahead and test it with the same names as before. You can see that we get a type error on line 27. And it says that the comparison less than is not supported between instances of string and int. So the problem here is that in order to concatenate these two numbers, we had to turn them into strings. So that, let's say that this number was equal to 5 and this number was equal to 6, then instead of getting 11, which is not what we want, we actually get 56 because they're both strings and these strings get concatenated together. But the problem occurs on the next step. Because we want to compare the love score against an actual number, then if it's a string, it's not going to work. So in order to solve this, then we actually have to convert the love score into an integer. So you could use a separate step. So the integer score equals int, and then we wrap it around the love score. Alternatively, and a lot easier, is to simply just wrap that whole line inside a set of brackets and convert the whole thing into an integer on the same line. It depends on how comfortable you are with this code as to which option you'll choose. Now that we're done here, let's go ahead and run our code again and let's just check it. Your score is 42, you are all right together. So now our code seems to be working and we've now completed this code challenge. How did you get on with this challenge? Did you manage to get everything right? Did you get stuck at certain places? Have a think about which parts of this challenge were the hardest and see if you can review some of those concepts so that the next time you encounter them, you'll be able to tackle them with confidence.